Biomass is everywhere. I'm surrounded by all kinds of plants and fields. And all this green nature around me is what we call biomass. On the Bloom Project, we look into new technologies and innovations of the so-called bioeconomy. In this episode, I'm on my journey to find out how it's possible to use sugar beets as a resource for creating sustainable products. We are at a large field of sugar beets. You might think it's impossible, but here we can use beets to make 3D printed objects that are biodegradable. How can you transform this beet into a chess piece, a vase, or a mouthguard for hockey? In the north of the Netherlands, a whole region has specialized in researching and developing how biomass can be used to implement a circular bioeconomy. Not far from here, there is a 3D printing lab. There we will meet Professor Jan Jager. He works at NL Stender University of Applied Sciences and knows a lot about the process of converting biomass into useful everyday objects. I got this bike from Dutch Fiets, a Dutch company who, with the help of Jan Jager and others, made this bike from recycled plastic. Your research is about transforming natural resources like sugar beets into bio-based objects. What is your motivation behind this research?
In general, plastics are produced from oil. But as you know, the availability of oil will be limited in the future. So there is a lot of work going on, some research going on, to develop new polymers, new plastics, not based on oil, but produced on biomass.
These objects are printed with a normal 3D printer. What is really special about it is that the material used for printing is 100% bio-based. But how is this possible? Jan Jager explained that the first step is the transformation of the sugar beet into the raw material for the bioplastic, called PLA, polylactic acid. But what is PLA? And how is it created? To transform the sugar beet into a bioplastic, first you have to take the sugar from the beet and start the process of fermentation. So the sugar gets transformed to lactic acid. After that, we put the catalyst to the cocktail, which lets the molecules stick together in a long chain, also called polymer. Because of these long chains, the material gets stable, like a conventional plastic. Actually, I found out that they don't produce PLA yet in the north of the Netherlands, but that there is a global market for it, which is where the institute buys it for their research. The north of the Netherlands is rich in agro-industry and invests a lot into implementing their own regional value chains. Sooner or later, they will be able to source their own PLA from their own local fields.
It's an interesting material because it's bio-based, it's produced from biomass, and in addition, it's also compostable. So you can develop new kinds of products where you make use of the compostability of the product.
These chips are PLA chips, but on their own, they cannot be used for printing. Students in this lab are able to turn the PLA pellets into printable filament.
From the PLA chips, you can easily make filaments, PLA filaments, for 3D printing. And when you have the access to a 3D printer, you can easily use the PLA monofilaments to make all kinds of new products based on the PLA.
These chips are introduced to the hopper. Under high pressure, they go through the extruder to be cooled down in the water bath. Ah, okay. These long spaghettis are coming out of this machine. Now it really looks like a filament. During my stay in Emmen, I realized that there is much more going on there than just using PLA for 3D printing. More and more companies are popping up using PLA as a basic material for developing all kinds of bio-based products. One of the companies developing applications from PLA and other biopolymers is Sembis Polymer Innovations. They produce bio-based yarns for the horticultural sector. This bio-based yarn, for example, can be used in horticulture to grow tomatoes in greenhouses. After harvesting the tomatoes, the yarn can be composted together with the leftover leaves and stems of the tomatoes. This saves work, time and money, as the yarn doesn't have to be sorted out separately.
We call us the green area. Green area where bio-based products, the development of bio-based products is the focus. So we work close together, we have students, where we do applied research together with the companies in this area.
Is bio-based the same as biodegradable? No, it's not. Bio-based means that something is made from renewable resources like plants. Biodegradable, instead, means that the material will disintegrate into nature when you compost it. After the lifetime of a PLA product, there are three different options. If it is biodegradable, you can compost it under specific conditions. Then there is the possibility to recycle it, or you can burn it, which should be the last option. I learned biodegradable does not mean I can throw it into nature, because it still needs a lot of time to disintegrate and could still harm the environment. Nearly every plastic today could be replaced with bio-based materials. But if we need natural materials like sugar beet to produce PLA, are we not wasting an incredible amount of food and land for the manufacture of consumer products? I went to Wageningen to find out more. At Wageningen Research, I will meet Harriette Bos. She is a specialist in bioeconomy and has been working on this topic for over 20 years. Let's see what she says about the use of biomass and if it competes with the land we need for food production.
So it's not necessarily bad to use a feedstock that you can eat also for materials, but you have to look at it at the complete picture. Even if we would use biomass for all the materials that we use, then it would only be a small percentage of everything that we produce to make our food. So this is quite a big difference in market size. So I think there's room there. There is no room to do all our transportation based on biomass, because that would be a too much big demand on our feedstock.
From your point of view, what would an ideal economy and an ideal world look like?
So in the ideal world, we would have crossed out everything from fossil feedstock, have other energy options such as wind and solar, etc., but also partly based on biomass, there where it's not easy to do something with solar and wind. And our materials are fully made from biomass, so every new material you make is made from a renewable feedstock, so no more oil. And we do this so efficiently that also in the same time we can also produce our food. And so this everything should run on biomass basically, and that's a tremendous difficult. So that's something that we are working very passionately here in Wageningen, but it will take some time.
Wow, this is really a great vision. And for me, the most fascinating thing about it is that in this region of the north of the Netherlands, it is already partly becoming reality.
Well, it's unbelievable that this comes from out of sugar beet. And I can make my own biodegradable object right here on a 3D printer. So let's start and print it.
If you can already print a vase from biomass, imagine how many of our daily projects could get bio-based in the near future.
Stay updated on how Bloom is engaging EU citizens and civil society in the bioeconomy and how you can get involved via the project website and social media, www.bloom-bioeconomy.eu.